Hello, learners and coders. My name is Sean, and I will be your instructor today. Welcome to this lesson of Coding with Sean. In this lesson, we will learn some facts about Microsoft's present day, Microsoft's founding, some facts on Microsoft's past, Microsoft's rise to power, some of Microsoft's most well-known and most useful services, Microsoft's way of functioning, of course, and some cool facts about Microsoft and my overall opinion and overview on Microsoft Corporation. So without further ado, let's begin. So some background information on Microsoft. The founders are Bill Gates and lesser known Paul Allen. Microsoft's current CEO is Satya Narayan Nadella, who succeeded Steve Ballmer in February 2014. The founding date of Microsoft is April 4th, 1975, and the place is Albuquerque, New Mexico, in the United States. Microsoft's annual profits measure $125,843,000,000 United States dollars as of 2019, and it is on the rise. Microsoft's headquarters are located in Redmond, Washington. It does have a cloud service, which is Microsoft Azure. It also has many domains, but some of the more popular ones and more well-known ones, as for the entry level, is .aspx, and for top-level domains, they have .microsoft and .xbox, which I'm sure you have experienced at least one of the three in the past. Microsoft employs 152,155 people as of 2020, and its stock is MSFT. So, the founding of Microsoft Corporation. Microsoft Corporation is and was a revolutionary company. It took people from using typewriters to using keyboards. Microsoft relocated to Washington State and soon grew to an enormous international corporation. In 1987, a year after Microsoft became publicly available, Bill Gates, at the time 31 years old, became the world's youngest seen billionaire. By 1979, Microsoft had become a million-dollar profit company. Adjusted for inflation in 2020, that would equal to over $3 million, which is very, very impressive for just a couple of years worth of running the company. So Microsoft made software and hardware for enormous companies such as IBM. Internet Explorer was also introduced in 1995 and was a hit. So some facts on Microsoft's past. The founders, Bill Gates and Paul Allen, were college dropouts. Microsoft was originally made to serve other companies, not a self-dependent company or corporation. They moved to Bellevue, Washington in 1979 because that's where Gates and Allen were born, and some other reasons such as finance. In 1983, Paul Allen had to leave Microsoft due to being diagnosed with Hodgkin's lymphoma. Luckily for him, though, he was successfully treated and came back to Microsoft. Unfortunately, though, after having a falling out with Gates and Steve Ballmer, he quit Microsoft for good. So Microsoft's rise to power. Microsoft started incredibly small. Not even half of the city of Albuquerque had heard the word Microsoft. However, in a matter of a few years, Microsoft grew into a giant multinational company that just about dominated the computer industry. As stated earlier, enormous companies such as IBM were leasing designs and softwares from Microsoft because how good quality and how good they were compared to the systems that existed in that day. Today, well over 20 million files exist in the .exe or .msi file formats, which were both specially designed for Windows. In short words, Microsoft has changed and redesigned the fate of this world. So some of Microsoft's best known and, in my opinion, best services in the order of popularity are Microsoft Azure, Office 365, which is now named Microsoft 365, and its subsidiaries such as OneDrive, Yammer, Microsoft Forms, etc., Microsoft Windows, Microsoft Windows Intune, the Microsoft SQL Server, Microsoft Visual Studio, and Microsoft's somewhat failed phone, BlackBerry. So let's move on to Microsoft's way of functioning, which is pretty much the main point of this video. So Microsoft's way of functioning is very unique and is little known. Each job has special permissions depending on the level. For example, Very few people have permission to enter a Microsoft data center because it has the public's information on it. If you're a Microsoft store manager, you may have permission to enter that building, but not that legitimate room with the public's data. In a simpler way, Microsoft operates in a sort of pyramid way. When I say pyramid, I mean the level of occupation you have at Microsoft really decides what you can and cannot do. Microsoft also has separate managers for each subsidiary, which is really the part in my other video about an introduction to operating systems. I had said something about OneDrive and how it has a CEO that is somewhat different from Microsoft, and this is where really I'm going to explain that. So, of course, Microsoft has full control over each subsidiary, but a manager is kept for each one. For example, there's one person who manages OneDrive, one for Microsoft Video, one for Visual Studio, one for SQL Server, etc., etc., etc. That's really what I mean. Again, Microsoft Corporation has full control over each subsidiary and can close it at any second that it chooses to, but it is very, very important to note that each subsidiary does have its own manager and it is sort of separate from Microsoft. Okay, so approaching the end, let's go ahead and do some cool facts about Microsoft and its co-founder Gates. Microsoft was originally named Micro-Soft. Every United States state except for California has more Microsoft Windows users than any other OS such as macOS. In 1998, the United States Department of Justice and some state attorney generals, I believe 20, charged Microsoft Corporation with violating antitrust laws over Internet Explorer. At the time, there were no free web browsers, and Microsoft released Explorer as the first. The court presumed this as an attempt to drive other competitors out of business, and that is why they were charged with that. Luckily, though, after 10 years, Microsoft was able to get out of that. And to be fair, they did not deserve to be charged with that because that is not their intent and it was not a harmful intent either. So Bill Gates, one of the co-founders, is an extremely generous man / philanthropist through the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. He has donated billions in the double digits. Bill Gates' full name? William Henry Gates III. So, my overview of Microsoft Corporation as a whole. So before I do actually say anything, I do want to say that I'm not actively trying to insult anyone or anything. This is just my opinion about the corporation. Microsoft is a company with a rich history and a brilliant foundation. I cannot even imagine Microsoft turning out to be any other way. Gates and others have truly made the company something mythical. I have immense respect for all who have had the pleasure of working with or for Microsoft. They are a company who are not just devoted to making money, but revolutionizing the world through their tech. Sure, they may have had a bumpy start, but you really do have to give them credit for all they've accomplished in such a relatively short amount of time. And of course, guys, if you do have anything to add or anything you think otherwise, the comment section is always open. If you haven't already, please do subscribe so I can keep making videos like this. And if you did like the video, please do like and share it. Thank you guys so much for sticking to the end. And if you do have any questions, the comment section is there for you. And I promise you I will get back to you. So thank you guys so much. And I really hope to see you in the next lesson.